Today I want to show you four hidden Excel tips and tricks that will help you create beautiful Excel dashboards or Excel reports really fast. I'm really curious though to know which of these tips, if any, are new for you and which of these you're already using in your files. Comment below and let me know. And if you also have any hidden Excel tips or tricks, share it with us below as well. Now, before we get started, I'd like to quickly thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Skillshare is an online learning community for lifelong learners like myself and probably yourself since you're watching this video. I'm going to chat more about them towards the end though, so stay tuned for that. Now, let's get to our four tips. Tip number one, convert SmartArt to shapes. So let's say this is the canvas of my dashboard. What I want to do is add in some shapes that are connected to cell values. So let's say these are important information. I want to highlight them and bring attention to them on my dashboard. Now my numbers are sitting on the calculations tab. I have sales information for three different apps. On the dashboard side, I want to show the sales for each of these apps for the first half of the year. Now I could go and insert some shapes from the illustrations group here, but I can also insert really nice shapes by going to the SmartArt feature. Here I get access to more professional and more complex shapes. I'm inside the All tab here, so let's go to one of these subcategories and insert one of these shapes. I'll go with this one and click on OK. Now I get a new tab pop up here in the ribbon for SmartArt design. I have the ability to make some adjustment to this. So let's actually update the color and use a nicer color combination. The disadvantage of using SmartArt is that you can't connect it to a cell value. So I can't click on this box here and then directly go to the formula bar and type in an equal sign and then put in a cell reference. But what I can do is to convert this to shapes. So just click on the border of the SmartArt, right mouse click, select convert to shapes. This becomes a grouped shape. So if you want to ungroup it, go ahead, right mouse click, group, and then ungroup. Now these become individual shapes. Now because they're no longer SmartArt, I can connect them to a specific cell value. So now with the box selected, directly go to the formula bar, type in an equal, then go to the cell where you want the value from. So I'm going to get this value and press enter. Let's do the same for the first shape here. So just click on the border of the shape. Don't click inside the shape, just on the border. Then directly go to the formula bar, type in an equals, and then select what you want. Now we can format these as we like. Just click on the border and adjust the font as you see fit. And then you can organize this as you like on your dashboard. Tip number two, hide unused rows and columns. When you finalize your dashboard, it's good to restrict the view for the user so that they can't use the cells on the side. So let's say you've put all the information here and you just want their attention to stay here. You can hide anything that's unused. So select the first column that you don't need and then use the shortcut key Control Shift and the right arrow. That's going to select all the columns, right mouse click and hide these. Now you've restricted the columns to only this area. They can't click away and they can't scroll to the side. Do the same for the rows. Control Shift down, right mouse click and hide. Number three, select objects from the selection pane. Once you have a lot of objects on your dashboard, sometimes it becomes difficult to select them from here. What you can do is bring up the selection pane by going to Home, Find and Select, Selection Pane. Here you can see all the shapes that you have. You can also hide shapes from view by clicking on this eye icon. So let's say you're testing if something looks better here or whether this looks better here. You can position them where you want and then hide the objects and see how it looks. It's also easier to select multiple objects by using the control key on here. So if I want to select a few shapes here, I can select it from the selection pane and then hold down control and select the other shapes as well. Tip number four, use a linked picture to overcome cell boundaries. Let's say we want to add a drop down to here where we can select the different apps. And what we want to see on the side here is the sales trend. So basically, we want to see this trend based on the app that the user selected. We're going to do that with a sparkline. Let's set that up really quickly. I'm just going to go to insert a data validation here. So let's go to data, data validation, list, and for source, that's going to be these three apps and okay. Now, when someone selects blend, I want to see the sales trend for blend right here. Well, first off, on the calculation side, I need to somehow figure out what the user selected. So let's say this is equals whatever the user selected here. Now that I have that information, I can grab the data that I need from my source data. So let's go old school and use the index function. The array is basically the range of my answers. That can be any of these. I don't need to fix this because when I pull this across, I want it to shift as well. Now for the row argument, I need to figure out how many rows to move here. So basically what the user selected. Here I can use match. My lookup value is this, and I need to fully fix this because I don't want that reference to shift. My lookup array is right here. Again, I need to fully fix this. And my match type is 0. Close bracket and press enter. We need to have a second bracket. Let's go with yes. And that's our value. Now, when I pull this across, I get the correct values for blend here. Now that I have that set up, let's add a sparkline. Go to insert. From the sparkline options, let's go with line. My data range is this one. Location is good and go with OK. That's the standard sparkline. I can update this by making it a bit thicker and also adjusting the color. So let's go with a yellow version. Now we can also add a low point and a high point here and adjust the colors for those as well. So for the high point, I want it to be light green, and for the low point, let's go with red. Okay, so we want to have this sparkline shown on our dashboard, but we don't want it to be restricted to the cell size here on the dashboard, because let's assume I can't adjust the size here. I need this cell to be this size. I might want to have a table down here, and I can't expand this appropriately for the sparkline. So what I'm going to do is to insert this sparkline as an image. I'm just going to copy it. So Control C, go to the dashboard side, and then go to the paste options here and insert it as a linked picture. Now I'm independent to the size of the cell, because it's now an object, a picture that's sitting on top of the cell. But the good thing is this is dynamic. It's not just a one-time picture, but it's basically a live picture that reflects whatever is in this cell. Okay, so when I change this now, again to voltage, I can see the trend for voltage, and then I'm flexible enough to position this where I like in the dashboard. As an alternative, you can of course use a line chart, but it will take some more time to set up the min and max dynamic formatting. Using sparklines and linked pictures can save you some time here. These were my tips and tricks when it comes to designing dashboards. Now for me personally, good design doesn't come naturally. I don't really have that feeling of what works good together. I had to educate myself. Now, if you'd like to learn more about best practice data visualization techniques, I can recommend the class Introduction to Data Visualization from Data to Design, which is on Skillshare. The course is by Nicholas Felton, who is an information designer. Now, he also mentions in the class that what separated him from the other people who also had technical skills were his design skills. My favorite lectures are the ones on color, typography, and designing the layout. So check it out if you're interested to improve your data visualization skills. I have a special link for you in the description of the video. Click that link, become a member, and you're going to get 2 free months of premium membership to all the classes on Skillshare, so not just this one. After the 2 months are over, if you'd like to continue with your premium membership, it costs less than $10 a month if you get the annual subscription. You have a huge variety of topics to choose from. For example, you have graphic design, you have web development, marketing, productivity, office tools, and so much more. Thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring this video and supporting my channel. If you enjoyed this, give it a thumbs up. And if you want to improve your skills, consider subscribing to this channel. Thank you for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video.